Shape keys are a way to change the shape of your objects. They will have the same vertices as before, only move to a new position, giving the object a different shape. Let's see how this works in practice. Remove the default objects and add a plane instead, so we have something very simple to test with. Go to front view and rotate it 90 degrees around X so it faces us. Change it to orthographic view so we can clearly see the location of the four vertices against the grid. Now, let's try adding a shape key to this plane. With it selected, go to the object data panel where they are located. The list is currently empty, so add a new shape key by simply clicking on the plus sign. A shape key called basis is added. This shape key holds the original shape of the object, the one we can see right now. To actually change this shape, we need to add another key. Click on the plus sign again, and another key is added. This time it is named key 1. Using this new key 1, we can give the object a different shape. But how do we decide what new shape the object gets? By simply going into edit mode and edit the mesh like normal. Just make sure that you have selected key 1 in the list and enter edit mode. Let's try to move one vertex to see what happens. I will take this one and move it one unit up. We have now given the object a new shape, so let's go back to object mode. The change disappears and the object looks just like normal. This is because the shape key is not activated. When we are in edit mode, we see the shape of the key we have selected in the list, so it is easy to edit. But to make it visible in object mode as well, we have to increase its value. The value is simply how much the key affects the shape. If we increase it, you can see how the plane is slowly turning into the shape we just created. And at a value of 1, it looks just like it. The value of the shape key can also be seen next to the name. There you can see how key 1 has a value of 1. Notice how the basis doesn't have a value like that. It is because it holds the original shape of the object. The other shape keys, however, is not storing a shape, only a difference. For example, in this key 1, it is stored that the top right vertex is moved one unit up. This difference is then added to the original shape in different amounts depending on the influence we choose. An influence of 1 adds the same change as I did when I created the key in edit mode. Since the shape keys below the basis only stores a difference, it means that no matter how I change the original shape, key 1 will still move the vertex one unit up. Let's try this to see. With the basis selected in the list, enter edit mode. Let's move the top right vertex one unit up. When we go back to object mode, the vertex is now two units up. In the original shape, it is one unit up, and then key 1 moves it one unit further. We take the basis and then add a difference. Change the base shape back to the way it was by moving the vertex down again. Now, let's try adding another shape key to see what happens. Click the plus sign and a key called key 2 is added. With it selected, enter edit mode. Always when you create a new shape key, the object will look just like normal in edit mode. This is because we haven't added any change to it yet. Let's adjust the shape by moving the same vertex one unit to the right. If we go back to object mode, the vertex is still moved just one unit up. This is because key 1 is still influencing the shape and key 2 is not. Decrease the first key down to 0 and increase the second key to 1. And now it points to the right. But what if we increase key 1 again? Now the vertex is moved both one unit up and one unit to the right. If you want to, you can think of the shape keys as a conveyor belt. First we take the base. Then we add the first shape key, which holds the difference, move the vertex one unit up. Then it moves on to the next shape key, which holds the difference, move the vertex one unit to the right. The difference has been added and this is the result. Really, it shouldn't be called a conveyor belt since the order of the shape keys below the basis makes no difference. We can move key 2 above key 1 and it looks no different. It is the overall combination that matters. But thinking of it as a conveyor belt might help you understand how it behaves. The influence of the shape keys doesn't have to be between 0 and 1. By changing the range, we can allow bigger and smaller values in the slider. That way, we can make the key affect the shape much stronger, or even give a negative influence, creating the opposite shape. With the key 1 selected, set the range from minus 1 to 3 so we can test. Let's temporarily hide the influence of key 2 by toggling the eye next to it. Now it doesn't affect the shape anymore. First, let's try a large number. If I enter an influence of 3, it takes the difference in the shape key times 3. So instead of moving the vertex 1 unit up, it is moved 3 units up. And if I give it a value of minus 1 instead, it is moved 1 unit in the opposite direction, going down instead of up. All very useful. This concludes the basics of shape keys. By just creating shape keys and then adjusting their influence, we can easily change the shape of our objects any way we want at any time. Thanks for watching.